In today's episode on Work Drive M, we are back with the Ford Mondeo. I have some good news and I have some bad news, of course. Let's start with the good news. I received the flex pipe for the exhaust with new gaskets, everything. I don't have to weld anything, it's just one piece. I received a new button and I've just plugged it in there and it's working. So now we can put everything back together here in the back and we can sell the car or we can repair the car, it doesn't matter. But now it will open all the doors in the trunk, of course. And I found some papers from this car. This is some papers for the engine check, as you can see in here, diesel. And this was done, oh my god, where is the date? Anyway, I'm gonna show you on the other one. And in here it says it's a pass. So smog, this car passed the smog. So the engine side is pretty damn good on this car. Everything was in Ordnung, okay. That means okay. Everything was okay on this side. On this side we have a list with everything that is wrong with the car and why it failed inspection. So we have a list, but it's not that bad. Not that bad. This is the flex joint for the exhaust. I'm done here because we already have that. We have some oil leaking on the engine and on the gearbox, but we can fix this. We just have to clean the engine and the gearbox and it will pass. We have some rubber joint for the axle in the front, it's cracked. After that, tires front and rear are bad. After that, handbrake, it's not okay. Oh my god, how this one is called? Tie rods, exactly. The tie rod on the right, it's done, but we can buy two of this and we can fix that. Brake lines in the back are corroded and we saw that. But other than that, everything is fine. And the owner tried to test the car in February. In this year. So I think we can put this back on the road and mostly we can fix it for our needs. We can carry a lot of parts and wheels and stuff for the garage, and I think it's worth it because all the parts that we need are not that expensive. I've paid like 50 euros for this joint and like, I'm not really sure, 10 euros for this. Of course are not high quality or stuff like that, but this car will carry all its life stuff, so it doesn't matter. And we have tow hook in case we need to carry some bigger stuff. And I've already talked with a friend of mine that is going to attempt, or if not, we are going to attempt together to fix these rot spots. And yeah, pretty much that's about it. So anyway, no more talking, let's start installing the button correctly. And after that, in the evening when it's not that hot anymore, I'm going to take my car out from the garage and we are going to put this on the inspection pit and install the flex pipe. First problem, these two are not the same. How crazy is that? And because on the original one we have this place in here and on this one we don't have that, we cannot push this here inside. See that? In here. So, okay, we need to order a new one. In a moment of madness, because the part doesn't fit, I've took it apart. I've took the switch out from the new one and I put the switch into the old one. And check this out. It's done, finally. Finally, it's working. So we can open and close all the doors. In the meanwhile, I've received the tie rods and the flex pipe, you know that. And we can move now the car into the inspection pit to fit those parts.
And we are in the garage now with the Ford Mondeo, and this is after a few days because, check this out, I've done it again. Last year I think I've had the same problem with the right leg and now with the left one. I was just driving a bicycle and I somehow clamped my leg between the pedal and the road. Yeah, strange. And it's like this. Anyway, and because I think I have more time to explain why I'm working on this piece of crap, maybe it's going to be easy for you to understand why. Because since I bought another house, I have two homes now, and I need to carry stuff like furniture and garden stuff and everything else. And this car was abandoned in a garden where I bought the house, and I received this car for free. And I thought maybe with 300-400 euros I can put this back on the road and it will have inspection for the next 2 years. And for the next 2 years, this one is perfect. 400 euros for 2 years is nothing. And I can carry stuff for the garage and I can carry stuff for the house. And I think it's going to do the trick. And from now on we have a tool provider and the parts provider, like oil and parts for the car. And like I said, we have tools. For now it's not anything sponsored. I paid with my money for everything, but we are going to use all the tools and the parts, and if everything is okay we are going to receive parts for the project. So anyway, now let's go under the car. I hope I will manage to go under the car to replace the flex joint. And I thought let's do a quick scan on the Ford, and for now no fault. Check this out. We don't have any kind of faults. It's perfect. Now we can start working on replacing parts. Let's start the car to see if it's smoking or not. Everything went very well. Not a single bolt was rusted or nut wasn't locked up. And now the exhaust doesn't hit anymore the frame. Perfect, perfect fit. The cheapest one on eBay, 50 euros. Fits like a glove. Just one gasket doesn't fit, this one in here, because as you can see there is a distance between these two ones and you need a different gasket. But luckily the original one was in good shape. And now let's make a leak test, and after that we can start here by removing the tie rods. Leak test was a pass, and check this out, this is the old flex pipe. Oh my god, it's done, it's garbage. Okay, so 50 euros well spent. And now in the front, I've already tried to remove the tie rod because I didn't know if it's going to go easy or it's going to took me a few hours, but everything went smooth. And this one is done. We have the new one in here. And the trick that I always use, I start removing the tie rod from the axle, from the steering wheel, and I'm leaving always this nut in here because it's the old alignment.
And I hope it's going to work. Either way, I'm going to do an alignment after everything is swapped. The brakes here in the front are not bad, are just rusted from sitting a long time. We still have some pads in there, and because we didn't have any complaints about the brakes in the front, just the handbrake, I'm going to leave it like this. Oh my god, that's a long thread. Anyway, I'm gonna update you when I've replaced both. And this side is done as well. This side is a little bit rusty, but everything will clean out when we drive the car. The new part in there, and we have both tie rods in here, are both shot. See that? That's one. Yep. And I think we are going to close the video in here because I don't have any other parts, and we have to check in the back because we have a list in there that the handbrake doesn't work. And we are going to do that in the next episode. And I'm going to close the video in here. We've done a lot of work. We just have to check in the next episode in the back to see why we don't have any handbrake or what's wrong in there. And I think after that we just have to sort some wheels and we can go for inspection. So if you want to see more progress on this piece of crap, join me on the next episode. If you like this episode, please give me a thumbs up. If you don't like the video, as usual, thumbs down. Until next time, see you later.